Good evening. My name is Mary Ellen Haynes, and on behalf of the Otterbein Choruses, I'd like to welcome all of you to our fall program, Every Time I Feel the Spirit. As you might have guessed after hearing our opening song and looking at your program, our musical selections this evening represent some of the best loved examples of the musical style known as spirituals. Because spirituals are lovingly sung in worship services all over the world, we sometimes lose track of the fact that they are, in fact, religious songs that evolved in the context of slavery. They were a mechanism for survival for African American slaves, an example of how humans can endure the worst conditions. As you listen to these incredible songs of hope and courage this evening, in the context of the pain and suffering that we still see in our world today, we hope that the words and music give rise to renewed hope, renewed conviction, and a renewed love for God and all of God's children. Our first spiritual tonight was the lively song, Little Innocent Lamb. Now we'd like to continue with the famous and hauntingly beautiful Swing Low, Sweet Chariot.
For to carry me home.
Now we would like to feature the Otterbein Women's Chorus in two wonderful spirituals. The first, the upbeat, Oh Mary, Don't You Weep, is a spiritual that originated before the Civil War. And as a slave song, it contains many coded messages for resistance, for hope, and for freedom. Secondly, the ladies will sing Jacob's Ladder. Many of you may remember it from your childhood, or from its use as one of the main themes in Ken Burns' documentary, The Civil War. This early spiritual appears to have been composed by American slaves taken from the area known now as Liberia. The lyrics emphasize spiritual growth, increasing one's knowledge about God, and a call to discipleship. Interestingly, it became one of the first slave spirituals to be widely sung by white Christians. Ladies and gentlemen, we present the Women's Chorus.
Thank you.
Rituals turned biblical stories into songs. Many centered on faithful servants of God who were saved from a sinful world of oppression. One of the most commonly referenced people in these spirituals is Moses, who delivered the Israelites from bondage in Egypt. The men's chorus will perform one of the most famous Moses spirituals, Go Down Moses, a spiritual that was sung by Harriet Tubman herself to signal that she was nearby and able to help those who wanted to escape their bondage. Interestingly, the men's final song tonight is not a spiritual at all, for spirituals have actually influenced many of the musical styles that followed, from blues to jazz to gospel and beyond. The men's gospel song, Lord, Listen to Your Children, is a powerful and poignant example of that influence. And now, the men's chorus.
Thank you. Thank you. All right. I am so pleased. Mary Ellen does such a wonderful job announcing things, and I always hate to take over from her because she does such a beautiful job. Would you thank Mary Ellen on her introduction? As much as I don't like to talk at concerts, I felt like the need to introduce this next group, basically because I have the privilege of hearing them every Sunday morning. And I just treasure that, and I know that you are going to enjoy their performance here today. The other piece of it is I know how much they love to sing spirituals, all right? And so you're going to hear some very special spirituals from them. I wanted to tell you a little bit about them. First of all, St. Columban, if you aren't familiar with it, is a Catholic church in Loveland. So they came a little bit from here. This group, Mary says, is open to all parishioners, high school age and older, and they sing for Mass every Sunday and for special parish events. They frequently work with other area choirs for projects and concerts like this. Large music festivals and so on. And we are really grateful that they are able to be here with us tonight. So thank you very much. I wanted to tell you about Mary. Mary has been the director at, I still can't believe this, she's been the director at St. Columban since 1932. That means... I told you, didn't believe that. Since 1992, sorry. And it's 31 years. This is why I don't talk. I asked Mary to tell me a little bit that she wanted me to share with you, and she said this. One of her favorite parts of her job is directing this choir, and she's most grateful for their dedication, their humor, and their welcoming spirit. In addition to Mary's musical duties in the parish, she frequently presents workshops about church music. She's also a faculty member of the Athenaeum of Ohio, where she teaches adults preparing to serve in parish ministry. And Mary and her choir are going to sing three songs for us tonight. Two beautiful, beautiful traditional spirituals. I have Steal Away, and I Want Jesus to Walk with Me. And in between those two will be another song that is not a spiritual, but as Mary Ellen described before, it's something that has been written more recently, and it's inspired by the spirituals, traditional spirituals. And as a matter of fact, if you look at your program, you'll see that it's a Moses song, except it's not about Moses. It was written by the very, very famous and esteemed conductor and composer, Moses Hogan. So, ladies and gentlemen, enjoy the St. Columban Choir with Mary Bellman. Thank you.
Thank you.
please thank our guests one more time? Now, some of you have been to our concerts here in the last year or so. You may notice a familiar face in the St. Columban tenor section today. Larry Reiring sings regularly at St. Columban as a soloist and oftentimes with the choir as well. And he is no stranger to us here at Otterbein because he was the soloist in our Broadway show last spring and then did this beautiful fall recital with us this fall. So we are really happy to have Larry back. He purposely, at the recital, didn't do any spirituals because he knew that we were doing that program. But I figured you'd want to hear him sing a spiritual too. Larry Reiring is going to sing This Little Light of Mine.
Oh, through Good evening. We are the Trebleaires under the direction of Monica Rudy, with Joan Wagner on piano, Trish Dicken on percussion, and Tammy Chamberlain on flute. While gospel music is generally thought of as an original American genre, it does have the roots in the 1730s New England. There are subdivisions such as Southern, bluegrass, country, and spiritual. Often well-known gospel songs are thought to have originated from slaves who were forced by their masters to attend the master's church. But whatever the origin, gospel songs share the themes of faith, culture, and social justice. And this is true of the three pieces we would like to share with you this evening. We open with Wayfaring Stranger, arranged by Greg Gilpin, one of our favorite arrangers. This well-known gospel folk song originated in the early 19th century, and it tells the story of the plaintive soul on the journey through life. Following the American Civil War, this song was often referred to as the Libby Prison Hymn, as the words were found inscribed on the wall of a Union prisoner's cell at the Libby Prison, which sadly was known for its extremely horrible conditions. The haunting history of this piece is reflected in its melody as well as its lyrics. Our second piece, Elijah Rock, is arranged by Dexter Johnson. And this song is said to have been written by the American African songwriter Hal Johnson in 1933. And so there are many that do believe that its origins certainly were spirituals. But this slave song embodies and symbolizes hope and resilience. We close with All Night, All Day, arranged by Greg Gilpin. This tune has been arranged by a large number of people in very many styles, but it never seems to lose that little calypso feeling. And this gospel lullaby is truly a song of faith and belief that as we travel through life, there are indeed angels watching over us. We hope you enjoy these selections. Ladies and gentlemen, the Trebleaires. Thank you.
Elijah Rock, shout, shout, Elijah Rock coming out, Lord. Elijah Rock, shout, shout, Elijah Rock coming out, Lord. Elijah Rock, shout, shout, Elijah Rock coming out, Lord. Elijah Rock, shout, shout, Elijah Rock coming out, Lord. Elijah Rock, Elijah, shout, shout, Elijah, Elijah.
So you got the spirit now? Thank you, Trebleaires. That was really wonderful. Thank you so much. All right, we are going to invite St. Columban to please join us on stage with both the men's chorus, women's chorus, and Trebleaires. And we are going to do a couple of tunes together for you, starting with the title song from our program, Every Time I Feel the Spirit.
Hey, back there on the
out there sing that when you were in high school? Anybody else? I mean, oh, it's just a favorite. I just love that. Thank you so much for, actually, that was Mary's idea to do that one. So thank you. Before we finish up, I did want to say a few thank yous here today, and I've got my own cheat sheet just so I don't forget anybody. I mean, obviously, we want to thank St. Columban for being here and for joining us. Did a fabulous job.
Thank you.
Thank the Trebleaires. All right. And the men's and women's chorus, who are wonderful. Also, our accompanists should not go unsung, so Joan Wagner and Leslie Hicks. Yeah. And I wanted to, I don't know if these people are still here, but we want to thank, first of all, John back in the sound booth. He does such a great job. And Kevin for helping set up all of the microphones and everything along with John. And a special shout out, thank you to Chris Ward, who is our music coordinator, who is currently in the hospital. But I know she's with us in spirit tonight here. So if you keep her in your prayers as well, that would be wonderful. So all of those people, thank you. So we have one more song today that we'd like to share with you, and it's a song with a message that is very relevant, especially in light of the last couple weeks, but it's been relevant forever. As a matter of fact, I have the introduction that was inside the music to this, and this is what the introduction said. Published in 1989, all right, that's when this song was published, and the publisher put in the program saying, in a time when we worry about racial tension and warlike aggression, music can offer solace. The text to this ancient song can counteract hatred. And he quotes Psalm 133, verse 1. Behold how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. And I think, you know, I think we need to hold, of course, in our hearts the people in the Middle East. And I think that we also need to look at that. It's easy to look at the Middle East and think, how can they just not solve that? And yet we look here and we've got lots of unity issues to solve ourselves. So we are going to ask you to join us today in helping to create that solace that the publisher said in this book, his introduction. We are going to ask you to help us to counteract hatred through song. So here's what's going to happen. All right. And I'm glad, it's Trebleaires actually, that they had you guys clapping and everything. That was your warm-up, okay? Just warning you, okay? So what's gonna happen here is that we are going to sing the verse of this song, all right? You'll hear the ladies sing it. You'll hear the men sing it with the ladies. And then you're going to hear us do a refrain. And the words are simply, unity, unity, Lord, we pray for unity. Okay? Easy words. We're going to sing it by ourselves twice. All right? And then I'm going to turn to you, and you need to join in that counteraction to hatred, and you need to sing along with us. All right? So you'll have heard it a couple times, and it's super easy. All right? Then, after you've sung it with us that third time through, all right, we've sung it twice, you sing it the third time with us, the fourth time, we're going to sway and move, okay? Very, very simple, and you don't even have to be standing up to do it, all right? And you just kind of, whichever way I lean and the choir leans, you lean that way, okay? Because spirituals and gospel music are not really meant to be concert songs. They're meant to be participatory, right? So you get to be part of this whole spiritual experience tonight, all right? Deal?
Yeah.
Okay, all right. Ladies and gentlemen, the combined choruses, Trebleaires, and St. Columban Choir on the song Unity. Thank you.